Aussie movie Ride Like a Girl tells the story of Michelle Payne's incredible win of the Melbourne Cup. The first woman, it only took 155 years. I sat down with Michelle.
Don't get political, Anne. Come on.
I sat down with Michelle and director Rachel Griffiths to find out how they brought Michelle's amazing story to the big screen.
We're set to go for the Melbourne Cup. Stand by for the race that stops the nation.
How can a horse that was winning come last?
Michelle, Rachel, fantastic to see you and congratulations. I was lucky enough to see this last night at Sydney's beautiful Cremorne Orpheum with my little girl, who's 11. And I was so excited to take her to see a movie that's directed by a chick, produced by a woman, about a woman, starring a woman. That was a good reason to go anyway. But then you nailed it.
Let the others ride the different trainers, why can't I?
Because you're not ready.
I'm ready, Dad.
That first time you sat down and saw your story on the big screen, what was that like?
I obviously had great faith in Rachel and I just couldn't wait to see it and went in there just thinking, you know, don't worry if it's not the same as your life, it's not going to be, just enjoy it. And I was blown away. It exceeded my expectations by 100%. I just absolutely loved it.
She'll come last, Dad.
Thanks, Steve.
Don't say it, Stevie.
Having Stevie play Stevie, how about that?
Best thing in the world. My whole family were not overly enthused about the film, but as soon as Stevie was cast, you know, the whole thing changed. He is so funny and so smart, and his little one-liners, you know, they're always making us laugh.
Can I do this?
I know the horse can. Going to be a champion.
The fact that Rachel was able to get that out of him on screen so naturally, it's like he was at home on the farm, you know, it was incredible to watch.
Did you always want to cast Stevie? And you had no idea whether he'd be able to do it, I guess.
Look, I did have another actor in mind who has done a lot and is really extraordinary, who has Down syndrome. I tried to imagine the conversation where I would explain to Stevie that somebody else could play himself better than himself. And I just couldn't imagine actually having that. So we did a workshop and he was absolutely beautiful and he delivered everything that I hoped. And you only want three things really from your actor. You want them present, emotionally available, you want them open to the person they're acting with, and you want them making creative choices. And Stevie just turned up and did that every day.
Get off me!
Get back to where you belong!
Your racing sequences were extraordinary. I guess your eyes, the critical one, but I felt like I was in the race.
I've heard
some racing peeps say that that's the best they've ever seen it depicted on screen.
We were very lucky. Simon Winter, who directed Farlap and The Cup, he said to us, oh, I'm so jealous you're making this movie now because the digital cameras, the small, the remote heads, you know, you're going to be able to do so many things.
Yeah, right up at the bot of the horse in front.
Exactly.
You know? At the Melbourne premiere, you were faced with some protesters against the horse racing industry. Were you surprised by that? And what was your reaction to what they
said? No, look, I'm a protester from, you know, way back, as you might know, Angela. So I wasn't surprised, but it did feel a bit like the militant vegans turning up at the Botanical Gardens on Christmas Day and yelling at people for enjoying their ham. You know, they'll never be convinced that we have world's best practice.
It makes me sad because they don't actually really understand how much we love these horses and how well they're pampered and cared for. And if something happens, it's a tragedy. It's like devastation. So that for me is like really sad, and I would love for them to see behind the scenes and, you know, learn more about it.
The only thing that matters is the odds you give yourself.
Said she loved it, I loved it. It's just, it's a true heroic Australian sports story, you know? And I think it's, and at all ages, the whole family can go together. And no one has to explain the plot to me, like Avengers.
That's right.
And I love as well. Doesn't Michelle's brother play himself?
Yes, Stevie.
He's hilarious.
Yeah, he's brilliant. Yeah.